Connecting Point recently spent a day up in Franklin County, and we're bringing you the stories about how they're working to survive and thrive in Western Mass. I went to Franklin County Tech School with executive producer Dave Frazier to learn more about their new way of teaching. If you came to Franklin County Tech School's machine tech program 1 year ago, it would have looked like this.
You saw some turning machines and some lathes that probably were in use in 1950. And half of them were broken. There were no parts available for them. So basically, the students were learning about turning technology and how to fabricate parts out of raw steel manually. And basically, we were preparing them for jobs that didn't exist in the private sector anymore.
Now it's asking you, which one do you want?
But that all changed when the new superintendent, Jim Laverty, met with local business owner Steve Capshaw, owner of Valley Steel Stamp.
He basically described what he thought was an archaic and way behind the times machine shop here at Franklin County Tech. And we got together and we basically made some contacts. He created a foundation that raised $217,000 in funding from area employers. He lobbied our legislators to get another $250,000, and we were fortunate enough to secure a $100,000 grant from the state for vocational equipment and put that all together and purchased 13 CNC machines from the Haas Corporation. And because we were doing it for educational purposes, Haas discounted them by $200,000. So in effect, we have $700,000 worth of equipment for less than $500,000, which basically had zero impact on the school district budget.
No impact on the school budget, but the modernized machines brought a huge impact on the enrolled students and the local community.
The majority of our employees over the years have come from the tech school, from the machine tech program, because it's the only program in the county that teaches the skills that our company and other companies like us need to be able to run complicated CNC machinery to make complicated parts.
One of those students going through the machine tech program is Alexander Barabin. He's already seeing the benefits that the school tech is teaching him, especially compared to his friends in a traditional high school setting.
They're coming out of high school and then they're looking for jobs. They're still wondering what their career is going to be. And then with this program, I already have a career set and all that.
And that's more than even some college graduates can say.
I had three individuals last summer that came to our company applying for a job. Great young people. They seemed like they'd be hardworking people. They had no discernible skills because they had a liberal arts degree. There's no offense to a liberal arts degree. I have a liberal arts degree. However, they had no discernible skills and we could not hire them. In each case, we had a conversation. They told me they had significant amounts of debt, no discernible skills, and were working a retail job, asking for me for a job. At the same time, we have employees who, if fully qualified from this school, we have an employee who graduated about a year and a half ago from this school that makes $60,000 a year with our benefits, which are 100% match 401k and 100% paid medical, addition to many other benefits, including full tuition reimbursement. And his future is incredibly bright. So I think people are starting to realize this. The facts are starting to come out.
Students are excited. They see the potential. They go to field trips to Valley Steel Stamp. They talk to the employees that are in that environment, and they see the potential. You know, a long time ago when I was going to school in the 60s, it was to get a good job, you need a good education. Many of our parents interpreted that to be a college education. Education is training, and we provide a lot of quality training here where these students can leave here as a senior and get a good job with good benefits.
This unique way of thinking that goes against the grain isn't just for high school students anymore.
One of the things I saw when I came here is that we have a building that's filled with millions of dollars of technology, and when the students leave at 2:35, it's empty. And why can't we fill up this building with adults to develop a retraining program? And got together with the folks at GCC and the Regional Employment Board, and we acquired another state grant for $236,000 to train adults, and our initial goal was to train 12 adults this fall. We ended up with 15.
Our success in the future is going to be based on our ability to harness high technology to be able to make really complicated aircraft parts, turbine parts for power generation, all the different components that we make. To harness that technology, we need our only local tech school to be able to teach kids and adults the skills that we need.
And whether training adults or high school students like Alexander, the new machines at Franklin County Tech School, they do more than just help the students compete for good manufacturing jobs. They give students that possibility right after high school, thus potentially changing their career and their life.